The Pope chose today to remind us of that. And what happened today in the afternoon is an adoration and benediction of Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, called Julia, if you we know what that is, because we have it here on Thursday. But today is a special one from 3 o'clock, I believe. So if you're free, you're not doing anything, it's not only in this church, if you're closer to another Catholic church, I hope you're doing it, they're supposed to, you pop in and spend that hour with our Lord in the Blessed Sacrament. There is something called plenary indulgence that we receive, especially today, if we participate in that. And to receive that, you participate in Divine Mercy celebration, usually from 3 o'clock, because 3 o'clock is the hour of mercy. That is the hour, traditionally, according to history, that Jesus died on the cross. So that is the hour that the divine heart is open. Mercy flows like from the Revelation to Saint Faustina, that I want to feel to her. So if you participate in that, and you have within a week, you take advantage of the sacrament of reconciliation, go to confession, then your sins are forgiven. That happens in always, you know, when we go to confession. But on top of that, this is what plenary indulgence is. I'm going to use an example of a wound and a scar. See, when we commit sin, mortal sin, it cuts us away from God's friendship and from God's power. Right? So when we go to confession, it restores us to God's grace. Right? But we still have to satisfy that. Right? We still have to make up for that. It's like, if you look at, if you see sin as a wound, when a person is wounded, you go to confession, that wound is healed, but the scar is still there. You still have the scar. And that scar has to be taken care of before a person can, a soul can enter heaven. Nothing imperfect can enter heaven. And that's where purgatory comes in, because the soul, I'll give you an example I use at the 9:30 Mass. Let's say somebody is a bad person and they went and killed like a million people. But before they die, they go to confession and they confess their sins and they're forgiven. But they still have to make up for what they have done. So through God's mercy, divine mercy, the soul goes to the purgatory to spend time to make the reparations, you know, for the horrible deeds that, you know, killing a million people is horrible, but they make it up. So that is it. So this in plenary indulgence that we receive, what it does, it takes care of the scar that the sin causes or puts on our souls. See, when a person goes to confession and healed, then the plenary indulgence that you receive on a day like this takes care of it. So the soul is like, there's a term they use in theology, new again, like on the day of death or baptism. So please, if you have the time, take advantage of it. It doesn't come very often. Another time I think that you can receive plenary indulgence is the First Friday devotions. I think you guys all know that. If you have a First Friday devotion for 9 First Fridays in a row and receive communion and confession and communion 9 straight First Fridays and First Saturdays, you also get some kind of indulgence. And what they do, like I say, is they remove the scar that sin causes on our souls after the sin has already been forgiven. So that's today at 3 o'clock. So if you're around, join us.